Hello, everybody. My name is Tom, and this is my carnivore success story. Dr. Sean Baker requested that people do a short audio recording of their carnivore success stories. And so this is mine. I've been on a carnivore diet for about 20 months now. I used to suffer from arthritis and psoriasis. Those were my primary concerns back then. I went from giving up the gym because I could barely turn a doorknob because the arthritis was so bad to going back to the gym and really smashing it. I have zero joint pain now. I don't run out of air like I used to when I'm doing cardio. I'm probably stronger now at 48 than I was at 28. So it's great. I love lifting weights, so it's great to get back into the gym. My hands were really bad. My feet were really bad. My neck was really bad. My lower back was really bad. And none of it bothers me anymore. I'm a little leery of my hands sometimes, but I've got one hand with a lot of scar tissue and broken bones I mended in it. So after having psoriasis flare-ups for years and really noticeable problems like bleeding through my clothes, a lot of itching and pain, secondary infections, putting on all kinds of steroid creams, taking medications, I'm down to just a little small patch of the back of one arm that seems to be going away. I've got some scabs here and there and some scars that seem to be all fading. And I'm relieved that I didn't have to take any biologics, take the health risks with that. I had really thick calluses on my heels that often cracked and got infected. It caused a considerable amount of pain, and this went on for decades, and that healed up too. I don't know why the calluses disappeared, but I suppose all these skin issues are related. I also had a condition called lichen planus on my hands and feet, toes and fingers. We get these blister-like growths that were just full of more skin. And sometimes they'd be painful, but for the most part, they're just kind of an aesthetic nuisance. I also suffered with allergies from the time I was a little kid. Watery eyes, runny nose, stuffy nose often led to sinus infections. And now I haven't gotten sick since 2017 with anything. No colds, no flu, no allergies, nothing more than the occasional sneeze. No sort of illness has come on that I haven't needed any sort of medication or need to see the doctor about or anything like that. So not even the seasonal cold. So it's pretty amazing. I used to have a great deal of anxiety, which has vastly improved. I rarely take any sort of medication for it now. Used to have a lot of social anxiety in particular, and I frequently would drink alcohol in social situations, so they were more tolerable. I also used to startle very easily. In fact, a lot of people have known me for a long time. They're pretty cautious if they're walking up, coming into a room, or used to spend a lot of time in my garage tinkering, and the neighbors would drop by, and a lot of them would know to, they'd whistle or shuffle their feet or tap on something, so I knew somebody was coming, so I wouldn't jump. So, you know, imagine what it's like when you're, you know, working with power tools or welding or, you know, whatever, and somebody startles you. So everybody's pretty good about it, except my boss, who really enjoys when she scares me, because then I jump so hard, she jumps really hard, and she's really amused by it. So good for her. And I used to suffer from heartburn a lot. I was taking Alka-Seltzer all the time. And I've had a lot of problems with sleep, and I sleep much deeper now. My Fitbit told me that I actually sleep more than the average person in my socioeconomic/age range or something like that, which kind of surprised me. I'm still working on that, still trying to be more disciplined about getting to sleep sooner, but I definitely have a much better quality of sleep. I also suffer from dyslexia and dysgraphia, which is improved quite a bit. I noticed that I can remember phone numbers quite well. Sometimes I remember phone numbers that I never intended to remember. I remember them in order, which is a big deal. It used to take me a long time to learn a phone number or PIN numbers and stuff like that. Now I seem to retain it quite nicely in order, which is very helpful. I've lost a considerable amount of body fat. I don't really know exactly what my body composition was when I started, but I'm guesstimating easily 50 to 60 pounds of body fat. I put on quite a bit of muscle. Putting on muscle seems to be much easier on a carnivore diet, at least for me. I've lost about 7 inches around the waist. And like I said, I'm 48 now, and I'm probably quite a bit stronger now than I was when I was 28. And I used to work quite a bit harder at it when I was younger. And I'm convinced that diet is, you know, maybe 90%. I think I was listening to John Anderson today, and I think he said it was about 75%. So somewhere in there, we're in agreement. So I really enjoyed the gym. I'm glad to be back there. I love lifting weights. And I really am concerned about the quality of life for people. A lot of people out there with all kinds of conditions that could be resolved with a better diet. So I think people should know that changing their diet and eating a meat-based diet or perhaps a meat-only diet could really change your life for the better. So anyways, I fully support this carnivore movement. I think it's going to help a lot of people. Maybe it's not for everybody, but people should give it a try and consider it. And really appreciate all the effort that Dr. Sean Baker, Dr. Monkey Arms, as I like to call him, has put into this. He's a great guy, and he keeps plowing forward, and he comes up with great ideas like this, and I appreciate it. And I know there's a lot of other people out there as well. So anyways, it's a great community. It's growing. It's easily accessible online. You can watch it on YouTube. Find it on Facebook. I'm on Facebook. I'm on YouTube as well. You'll see them on Twitter and Instagram and everywhere. So anyways, check it out and see if it helps you resolve some of your issues. Anyways, thanks for the opportunity to do this, everybody. And I hope everybody feels better.